Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of City Skylines. So, between episodes, I did do one thing, and that was switch out this commercial area, also this residential area, to now be a commercial area. Yeah. But yeah, trust me, it used to be a residential area. Right, so there we go. There we go. That's only three houses. No. I mean, to be fair, they do have compensation over here if they need it. Since half the buildings were abandoned over here anyway, so. I mean, these guys just having problems. I'm going to give them another medical clinic, because I really honestly don't care about their little problems. Yeah, them and their problems can just go F themselves, you know. And this will kind of be like right over here. I mean, it's kind of close to both. Ah, whatever, might as well get another one in here. In the commercial district, of course. Or the commercial part of this district. Is there any schools over here? There's one school. Well, this is a thing. Yeah, there's no high schools. Pretty darn sure that one elementary school is completely filled. I mean, this place has a school that pulls. No, it's not even half full. Oh my god. We've got teachers in there probably with like 15 student classes. Oh wow. Nobody likes Nestor. Oh, Lily LaRue is at 100%. I might as well upgrade it. Oh my god. That looks better already. There's a concert going on. I know, never mind. I've already had a sold out concert. Um, 77% sold out, and that's not even close. 10 concerts played, 8 out of 18 band prepared, at least 85, so yeah, I've got 100. So yeah. I mean, there's residential demand, and there's residential over here, and my god, the commercial's going mad. You guys just really need workers, don't you? Well, if the stupid residential people were to build, then... There you go, I mean, these things must all just be fully upgraded. Beach Park has 7,600 people living in it. Concord Hills, a measly $43.99, which is more than I thought. Walnut Square has none, but it's not a residential district. City Square has 3,600, and where's the line? It's right there. I mean, City Square is pretty big. Up here it's going to be another district. That's probably going to be a district. And that'll be a commercial or a tourist district, and that'll be a leisure district. But what about Daunton Square, 6,500? Beach Park is the most so far, and Dale Square is 1,160. I'm going to name these eventually. Just look at that train track just running right through the city of Sunnyside Park. Sunnyside Park. That is actually a pretty horrible name. No, I did a mistake. Okay, there we go. I made a mistake. And this road right here somewhere turns to like a normal road in Sunnyside Park. So 100 here, 60 here. So it's like 40 here or something, and then it goes back to 100. I don't get it. And I built the damn thing, for God's sakes. You can't have it being a savage. You don't have enough money to have the planes be sitting here for months and years. Okay, I'm just gonna get rid of these beach bonanzas and assessments. Not now, but after this recording session. Because that is honestly just stupid. No, I was actually connected through, which I didn't think was physically possible. Maybe all of that, except for the bits that are over here, can be industrial. That'll be commercial, that'll be commercial. There's a few splotches could be commercial, and that could be commercial. But it looks like the residential's pretty much built in. I mean, I guess I'm just gonna go in like that. And honestly, all the abandonment is driving me crazy. Oh yeah, these guys I can get. They don't actually have water or anything, and they're not even close to it. So there you go, there's some water for you people. For you amazing people living out in Cedar Square. Cedar Square is about to be a city. The limit's 4,000 nowadays, I mean that is incredibly low. We've also opened them at 10,000. Between the town and the city, so. I mean, the city on it is like 25,000, so yeah. That is way above the limit to be a city. So they get 4,000. God, this highway is really popular with people. Oh, they're all trying to get it to harbour, aren't they? Well, I mean, just use the bleeding train, you idiots. Did I miss something with the train line? Knowing me, I probably did. Because I've never ever once seen a train go down here. But no, we actually didn't. Whatever, it doesn't really matter. Oh yeah, and the in-city line. And so that's that cargo train station. I mean, only the industrial areas will have regional lines. It has to be kind of close to that one. To be honest, I would have thought that would have looked 10 times worse than it did. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the audio doesn't work for some reason right now. In cities. I mean, I would give those guys some power runs of housing, but I really don't feel like it. No, it's pretty much level. I mean, that isn't. It's going to be quite a chunk to get up. Right, so how about, oh, you fit it right there, so the rest of the problems are for later. No, no distance too short, there we go, no distance too short isn't actually a thing. Oh my god, that is ugly. That is really, really ugly. And I really do feel like these people need their own cargo train station. I don't know where to put it. Oh, I think I know now. Hold on. I wouldn't see this kind of terraforming something that wouldn't be normal, that you wouldn't see in the real world. Because, yeah, I mean, terraforming isn't. I mean, like, terraforming is kind of like the last resort. Well, the last resort. So you would go to if you were like a city. Right, so there we go as well. We have these cargo train station network, which starts out over here. As you can see over here, so up here, we should probably get one into the Sheffield district, but we won't. I'm sending you the Delta Square one, Thornton Square one. Right there. It'll be a little bit of a noisy area for sure in Thornton Square, but it's fine. Then we'll get one in Cedar Square and possibly one in Concord Hills slash Beach Park. Probably Concord Hills, which will serve Beach Park. Maybe one in Florence, I don't know. Right, see the square, we just nudge one in like there. I mean, if you lost your commercial location, just build one like right there. There's a billion abandoned buildings. I mean, to be fair, that look was kind of unnecessary in the first place. might as well get that. Cargo train terminal. I mean, that's kind of close. I mean, it kind of serves this area. I mean, the Thorn Square one might just serve a lot more districts than intended. I mean, there's probably going to be one over here. I mean, Thorn Hills on Thorn Square. Let's see how that all works out. I mean, I'm not going to go bypasses because that's going to be impossible. And that's the region. I mean, that's all. I've already got vehicles driving in and out. So maybe there will be a train coming soon. I mean, the way to get to Thornton or Cedars, Cargo Train Station, is really just bridges and tunnels. So bridge, tunnel. You're actually not on land at all. Like normally more than 20 meters, except for when you're like at the station. I mean, it's not 20 meters now, but right there really. But I mean, more like, I don't know, 10 meters. I mean, these things are kind of iffy places. Like, just look at that, that's not a realistic location at all. And come on, it's in the middle of a residential district. And this one, yeah, it carves out the edge of a mountain. Just so you can have this beautiful little thing. I'm probably just going to flatten it up. I mean, it looks hideous at this point. I mean, it is going to be higher than the rest of the ground, so it won't get flooded and stuff like that. Right, so here you go. Now, just in case I'm going to have to extend that line, I have adequate space all around to continue the line. I mean, there you go, guys. There's just a little bit of an extension of the area, just to get people moving in here faster. And because this coverage kind of sucks, might as well just get the coverage out here. I'm not going to get a school or anything, that they can just go to the mainland for that. I mean, the schooling is terrible over here, but, well, to be fair, there are no high schools or elementary schools, but you can just go to Thornton. I mean, this part of Thornton doesn't have anything, but they can just go to the other parts of Thornton. I mean, Dale might, probably should get an elementary school. Possibly even a high school, but the high school might go on the island. That'd probably be a horrible idea for traffic. The traffic already sucks. I say that as there's nobody using this bridge. But traffic, like, would suck. But, I mean, don't nobody lives out there. But, since the only mode of transport, or the only mode of cargo transport, like a couple of train stations over here. Yeah, that won't help anybody at all. See, I think that'll get working on the bus line that kind of feeds through this area and it loops around the stadium. No, still needs to be closer. Right there. I mean, they can just walk. I mean, it's better to be over here. Wow, it actually considers that quicker. I mean, I can't really argue with it. I mean, that's what it wants and that's what it gets. If we do that just loops from there. And yeah, we can complete that. Why the hell are you adding so many vehicles? This bus line is, I mean, it's kind of a long bus line. And there's tall people waiting for this option. I guess I'm just gonna give it 10. Well, that's actually quite a few buses, but there's not as many as some other places have, but I'm just gonna give it 10, you know? Can connect the tram line that runs over here. We can connect the bus line that runs over to downtown Bloomington. Apartments for hilarious. Sheffield District has 846 people. Which all live over here, I guess. And I don't think there's any residential over here. And we still have a couple of months to the next game. We cancelled 3-3-2027, 3-1-2029, we won 2-2-2028, we also won. What the hell is happening? Can we change our name anywhere? No. Football Stadium? I mean, that's a dreary name. Nobody's ever going to get that. Hey, the Big Bite Stadium. There's 31 people on that train. It's better than I thought. Train this 28. It is the Dale Square Express. I mean, Dale has 1,200 residences in it. A rather large section of industrial and a huge commercial district. And not to mention, it has Wright Street. I mean, nobody cares about Wright Street, but I thought I might as well mention it. It's one of the most notorious things to see there. Yeah. That is not legit at all. Let me just rework the power lines a bit. So, there we go. So I think I'm going to end this episode here. Don't worry, I'm going to make another one like right after this one. So yeah, I thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next one. Goodbye.